Look, like you were talking, we're here real late. So if you get in the mindset, yo, tournament's over, let's go home, I wouldn't blame you for that. So it's good to get it out before the grand final. Speaking of here, Wishes versus Jen. Wishes Inkling versus Jen's Palutena. Now is the time to bring it back. Jen was sent to losers by Wishes, so we'll see if he can bring it back this time around. Oh, that was... So he actually probably could have gotten a little bit more of a chase out of that one, but that was a good response to the blaster coming out from Inkling. I don't actually know what to properly call that.
Wait, the what?
The neutral B, Inkling's neutral B. I don't know what I should call
Splattershot?
That. Splattershot? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, you're right, actually. That is a great word. All right. Chases off stage. Palutena getting early percentage ledge guarding is not too scary with Palutena, but she can rack up the damage real quick. And Wishes not letting Jen back for free.
Okay, going to be able to go center stage, connect that grab, down throw. Not going to get too much damage off of it, but
Jen's... Oh, gets out of the roller. That was smart.
The thing is, you know, just purely jumping gets him out of the roller, but the problem is we saw what Wishes was doing in previous sets. He was calling out these jumps to anti-airs with up smashes, so the rollers could be a potential way to just kind of condition Jen into jumping.
Speaking of, you just saw it right there. Wishes was looking for that, and Jen, having you know taken his notes from the last set, held his shield on that one, did not bite and did not eat that up smash, gets a full punish off of it.
Adaptation coming in strong, pretty even game so far, gonna end that roller prematurely, tries to go for the grab instead, get the up air right afterwards, because he wasn't on a platform, wasn't able to get the kill, but connects a second up air, take away that first blow.
I was gonna say, if he could have made it back down, that might have put him outside of the percent where he could have gotten that throw into the up air.
You see that grab connect from a mile away? Palutena's grab range is redonkulous.
Yeah, Palutena, look.
Like, he was rolling away.
Palutena is a pretty alright character.
Get over here. You heard my man's? Like,
all right.
Yeah, 126 on Wishes. Dash tactic, you know, just stuff out any aggression from the air.
All right.
Nice patience. Jen's starting to get these roll habits from Wishes a bit. Down tilts to poke him up. Didn't get the confirm right afterwards. And literally just one grab away from sending him flying. Or just, like, the smallest little hit. Like,
Did you see that weak hit up air? Still kept him on the platform, then he chased afterwards. That was kind of sick.
Very smooth placements coming from Wishes. Landing these aerials.
Yo, so got him with the sour spot of that. Palutena actually right in the middle there, so I don't know if the sour spot is in the middle or not. But
there we go.
Okay,
sends him flying back here, but Jen's already taking a beating in this second stock.
Mm-hmm. Does take a little bit of time dashing around there, gets the ink off of him, which is very good. Yo,
Wishes,
he was mashing the throw.
Super hungry for that grab.
One of the three wishes was going to be, hey, can I please throw this man back off stage? But the answer is no.
And honestly, that was probably the most optimal punish to the roller, right? Because Wishes, whenever he hits the shield, like most pro Inklings, they're probably going to go for a jump right afterwards. And that's why Jen automatically went for the Nair, and Nair starts the Nair terrain. Wasn't able to get too much damage off of it, but it's certainly probably the most damaging combo he could have got.
Yes. Low percent especially. And you see, Jen, he did jump out of his shield again a moment ago, but this time he had jumped away. Yo, he still didn't make it. I'm surprised.
Yeah, it's the second time we've seen Jen not make it back to stage from warp just because of like the angle he was thrown at. Now all that ink on him is going to lower his defense by 50%. Oh, God.
Still, he can play back a little bit to try to wait for it to go off, but then that gives Wishes full control of the stage to do what he pleases. Gets the splatter bomb just on top of the platform, sharking him right now and difficult to come down.
And that was Wishes calling out Jen's aggressive landing. You saw him trying to land down with the Nair, had a splat grenade with his name on it. Down air, try to poke him up with a two tilt, because honestly, if he gets a down air, or down tilt rather, that could easily lead into a kill.
Yes.
At this percent.
Oh, speaking of a kill!
So Explosive Flame's going to find its mark. A very safe tool to throw off while you're mid-stage against Inkling. And now Jen, again, we've seen this time and again, he's bleeding a bit.
Yo, he knew!
He went for the re-grab!
He knew!
Wishes!
He knew he was not in the percent. He didn't chase it. He went back to the platform.
He made Jen feel scared. Can we see a replay of that last kill? Actually, just watch them all. Screw it.
Yeah.
Like, the last replay, like, he literally baited that so hard because he up-threw him, just stood patient, waited for Jen to, you know, give him, like, that defensive reaction, went for the air dodge, mashing it, which just kept his cool, stayed on that platform, got the grab right afterwards. Let's watch that again.
Yeah, look at it.
So check this out. The up-throw.
Throws it. He knows he does not have it.
Oh,
and
sorry.
He chases.
It was a Nair. But regardless, he was too far away for the Nair to connect. So let's jump back into Battlefield. Game number two. Wishes is up 1-0 in this first to two. Race to two, if you will.
Yes. Oh, I see what you did there.
Okay, right. Dash attack. Try to call him out again.
Okay, so does get him with the last little bit of Nair there for the platform.
And that's the good use of Palutena's Nair whenever an opponent is like laying down on the platform like that. It gives them the ability to be able to just like, it's long lasting. So even if they mix up their timing and when they get up, it'll still work. Mm-hmm. It goes through invincibility as well if they just decide to lay there.
Yes.
Take a little snapperoo.
Yes, absolutely. It's active for a very long time, has a very generous hitbox. And then, of course, the suction is good enough that if you do get one hit connect, you'll probably connect with the rest of it.
Okay, Jen finds himself with a lead.
Nice. That was kind of a little tricky Nair that I haven't seen him pull out before. He let him cross him up and then did the Nair retreating and still managed to get it off.
I like this ledge trapping coming from Jen. You see him going for the retreating back airs. The second time he's won the duel.
Yo, he just waited.
There. Roll again, my guy. That's the third time he's pushed him back off stage.
Can we see a
fourth?
Waiting.
Can we see a fourth? Good night. My man was on that ledge for 30 seconds.
Yo.
Could not escape.
He was keeping him out. Yo, okay, tries to go for the jab, actually gets out of it before he can be rabbited.
Pokies.
Jab reset. Yo, okay. Yo, this is a lot of percent to eat.
So this is very similar to the previous set in Winner's Semis, right? Mm-hmm. Because what happened there is that Jen got annihilated game one,
yes.
And then Wishes brought it back. Or game two, game one, I forget what it was. But guys, the final game was Jen started to almost bring it back. It was an insanely close set, and that's what we're seeing right here. Mm-hmm. Except this is not even close. Jen is running... Just he's steamrolling him. Like,
yeah,
look at this. 109%.
He's running a steamroller on him right now.
Yeah.
Honestly, Inklings could stand to take a tip or two from that. All right. Not a bad falling up air. Just trying to find something on there to close the stock out.
There we go.
No such luck.
Back here. Oh, you put that grenade away.
That was dead
punishable.
Center, too.
Punishable.
You think you've got a grenade? I've got artillery, son. Stand right there. I got the coordinates locked in for you. Yo, Jen's gonna pop it off on this game. Look at him go. He's
locked
not letting
and loaded.
It stop.
My God, 66% already?
My God or my goddess?
On Gons.
Oh, boy.
This is my Gons.
Yo.
Backer?
All right. Good job getting back on stage. Time to ledge trap.
Good avoidance from that grenade. You saw the way he recovered. Bush is just going to pop him up into that up smash. But it might be a hair too late. He's already at 104%. Jen still has two stocks to play around with.
One stock down. That's
good
it.
Night.
Good night.
JV3.
JV.
If that is not an answer to the game one, to just send home a message, mm-hmm. like you know Wishes has got to be shaking a little bit from that because that was explosive. Mm-hmm. What an answer!
What an answer. What a pun. What a set. So we're going into game three. Remember, if Jen wins this one, he will reset, bring us to true finals. And that'll bring, coincidentally, their set count in bracket day for 1-1.
And also makes us stay later.
Yes, it will.
But hey, so Wish is like, you know what? I'm going to put that Inkling away for a sec.
So now, this is interesting. You were talking about this before. Wishes, in his game one, lost with Joker and then moved over to the Inkling. So now we're going to see if he can mix things up a little bit.
A reverse.
Yes. Because if we see him have problems with this one, then we could maybe chalk it up to, maybe he's not feeling the matchup with Joker. But if he can make it work, then it's more about how he's been mixing up his play styles in between. And honestly, it is quite a different beast having to deal with Joker's... I don't even know if I can call it zoning. He does have zoning tools, but the way Wishes plays him, it more is like, yo, I'm going to be a little obnoxious over here. You don't have to walk into it, but you can. And I'll let you. All right. A lot of slides. A lot of ahas. A lot of yeehaws. A lot of guns.
And Wishes is moving a bit with Joker. You see him going for these little gun specials, or just gun in general, mid-air to give himself a little bit of tricky movement.
Look.
And Jen might not be ready to adapt to this.
Yeah. See, it's sort of tough to deal with because you have to be ready for it and then move to the side to punish it.
Now,
although Palutena does potentially have a punish in back air. That was really strong.
The gun is turning into gun special. It's going to do three times as many bullets.
Yep. Wish is firing shots on this one. He was ready for
Okay. Right now he is fishing for this back here.
He's kind of fishing. He's looking a little bit like Isabel.
The thing is, he can afford to do it because it's pretty safe on shield. And Jen was playing extremely passively in that entire segment. Those 30 seconds,
Arsha
that was
so aggressive.
Ahana,
why?
Back here.
Stop.
Back
just reset to ledge. You can do it. There you go. Well.
Jen's trying to push the issue. I mean, he listened to you, Gretchen. Look what happened.
You're right.
Look what happened.
I'm not the one in Grand Finals
you
right now.
You sit in your chair and you commentate. You have never been in Grand Finals of Xeno, man. That is
damn
what
right.
He's telling to you.
Damn right. Absolutely right.
Oh, here we go. Wishes, getting that grab, up throw, back air.
Yo, big the A-hot chase. I also like how he had used gun over there, single hit gun, and then went for the down tilt.
Great.
As sort of a mix-up.
I mean, honestly, if Jen's going to keep spamming those projectiles, it's just going to give him a free charge to Arsene. Yep. Rebel's Guard coming into play. Aegon.
Right. Yeah, that actually does like a full Smash Attack's worth of damage on the connect.
Yeah, plus a, you know, that little poison effect afterwards, or curse damage.
Yeah,
rather.
That's what I mean. That dot does like 20%, which is crazy.
For those that don't know, dot stands for DOT, damage over time.
Stands for DOT. It is DOT.
Right.
Yes.
Damage over time. Regardless.
For those
dash attack, get him out of here.
Yep. See, we're seeing some damage over time to Wish's stocks, but Jen himself is not looking too pristine on that. Sitting at 113 on his second. Honestly, especially when Arsene comes out, he's maybe only a straight hit or two away from being down on his last, his tournament stock. Yeah.
You see my man just trip him a bit with that back throw.
Yep. Ooh, that was a good chase.
Jen attempting to try to defend New York City. Like I said.
Ooh, he got the re-grab.
I said this time and again, Gretches. This is going to be the first time that we've had an Invader win a Xeno for Ultimate since this game's release.
Yes.
And this would be a really big deal for Wishes to actually do that.
It's not free yet. Yo, tries to get him. Nice. Tournament stock.
This is New York City's last hope. Jen needs to take these two stocks without dropping a single life.
Mm-hmm. Wish is taking a deep breath. He's saying, oh, please, Genie. Oh, please.
Things are looking bleak.
Bring it to me.
Aegon wasn't able to connect, find its mark. Jen praying a little bit. Yeah, I respect that up air. He was hoping that Wish was going to play a little
counter.
Bit aggressive.
All right.
He wants the grappling hook.
Yo, okay, Rebel Guard through the up air. That was a really good idea. Nice landing idea. That's honestly kind of hard to whiff punish in the air if you're trying to catch a landing.
Now we got the dash attack ready to go. Catches the up air. Defuses the meter as well, by the way. He almost had Arsene out yet again. That would have been devastating for Jen.
That is honestly a really big proponent as to how this last stock turns out.
And Big Brother comes out.
Not having Arsene is a huge deal.
Yeah.
Arsene is daddy coming in this room saying, okay, son, you can stop playing Smash now. It's time to go home. It's late. This is grand finals. I don't care. We're getting in the car.
Yeah, he's got Jen 97% trying to connect that Aha off stage.
Yo. Yo. Oh, my gosh.
The grab. If you just would have played patient and called out that air dodge. Now we're chilling
okay.
Center stage.
You saw him trying to chase on what looked like a neutral air dodge down for that grab, but that's...
Wish is flubbed! That was an input error. He tried to go for a trump. Because Wish has never gone for a trump this entire set. That definitely would have killed, because that would have gotten into a back here. This tournament should be over, but Wish is flubbed.
That's not... Okay, Arsene's out on the board. Oh, that Aegon.
You saw Jen not even commit to that air dodge. He knew he could just drift away to avoid that.
Oh,
they're exchanging downers on shields.
Oh my god, stop.
Explosive flame sends him flying. Tries to attack on some more damage as he tries to challenge against the Arsene.
Remember, the more he hits Arsene, the less time he has spent out there. So if he gets another straight hit on this, he could take it over.
Okay, he's timing him out. Oh, no! As Arsene disappears, connects the final back air. You saw Jen trying to re-grab the ledge afterwards to regain invincibility. Just trying to wait out Arsene that entire time. But Wish just manages to connect the final back air. New York City has been defeated.
Yes.
Who sucks? We suck.
Oh.
Who
not
sucks?
Only that, not
New
only
York City
that,
sucks. I'm New Jersey, bro.
Not only.
I'm New Jersey, Ralphie.
Not
well, how's
only
it going, man?
That. Well, whoever you want to ask, remember, you hear the New Jersey, the New Jersey's the little brother sort of argument, right?
Yeah.
You know, it's sort of like a passive thing to New Yorkers, I feel, as someone coming from out of state. So seeing this is a blow to the pride. But if there's one other thing you can count on besides the New Jersey trash talk, it's New York pride. And I'll be damned if people here, Jen, Utopian Ray, because we saw him lose earlier to Wishes, we're going to see Nixie. I think they're all going to come back with a vengeance next time, especially if Wishes is here.
FNY, man.